So here we have the patient's maxillary and the mandibular casts that are mounted in centric relation. In this video, I will show you how to program the articulator, which means customizing the condylar guidance with the help of the protrusive record. In this particular articulator, the lateral condylar guidance is prefixed at 15 degrees, and thus we will use the protrusive record only to gauge what is the correct horizontal condylar guidance angle of the patient. For this, three things need to be done to prepare the articulator. First, we lift up the incisal pin so that it is no longer touching the incisal table. As I now come on top of the articulator, here we open up what is called as the centric latch. Once the centric latch is opened, the elastics are also released. This allows for the entire upper frame to be moved the way we wish for. We now take the protrusive record and we seat it on the maxillary cast. As I close down, you can appreciate that the teeth do not intercuspate into the wax wafer. This is because the casts are mounted in CR, but the record is protrusive. So to take the mandibular cast into the record, what I have to do is gently push the maxillary frame behind. And as I push that, you can now appreciate that the mandibular teeth go and fit into the indents perfectly. At this point, when you look towards the back end of the articulator, you are able to appreciate that the ball is no longer in the fossa, but it has translated out of the glenoid fossa because this is a protrusive relation. Now, as I zoom in, you will be able to appreciate that the ball here is not actually in contact with the fossa. If you look closely, there is a slight gap between the top of the ball and the top of the fossa. Now, when I open this condylar lock, I will be able to change the condylar guidance angle of the articulator. As I open, you can appreciate I can change the angle from here. Let's zoom in and look closely. The ball is not touching the glenoid fossa at this time. However, when I put my finger here and gently push this down, at one point the ball comes and touches the fossa. The point at which the ball touches the fossa is the horizontal condylar guidance angle of the patient on that side. Here, as you can see, the H value of the patient is 30 degrees. The moment I have this, I once again go ahead and lock the condylar lock. This means the H value on this side on the articulator is locked. I go ahead and repeat the exact same thing on the other side.